Hi Pisces, welcome to your December 2018 reading. This is going to be for Pisces, Sun, Moon and Rising. Guys, those of you are already subscribed to my channel, thank you and welcome again. Thank you for your support guys, and those of you who are new to the channel, welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Ayushi and I'm from India, and this reading is going to be for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising for the month of December 2018. Guys, if there is disturbance in audio, kindly excuse me for that. Also, I live near the railway track and there is a lot of noise outside of my window, so you will have to ignore it because for now I cannot fix it. So let's see what's coming up for Pisces. Reading is for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising. Messages for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising. What are we getting for Pisces? What are we getting for Pisces? Universe, please guide us. Please give us the messages for the sign of Pisces. 10-card Celtic Cross. End of the year 2018 December reading for Pisces. What are the important messages coming in for Pisces? I think we are ready to go. Bottom of the deck, Mother of Pentacles, Two of Cups, Nine of Pentacles, Three of Wands, the Justice card, and Two of Pentacles. So the message that I'm getting here is that let me put it. The message that I'm getting here is that you are waiting for something to come your way. You have done something, you have accomplished something, you have been self-sufficient, you have been working on your money, if you're not working on your money, then it just shows me that you are financially very independent right now, or you are just living a very lavish lifestyle. This can be you falling in love with your own self, or this can also be that you are dealing with a Libra or a Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. And the other message that I'm getting here is that you are trying to balance two things in your life. You're trying to keep a balance in whatever that you're dealing with. You're trying to do two things together, or you're trying to date people. Some of you are really, really, really in love with somebody. This person also loves you back, especially if this person is an Earth sign or has Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising in their chart. Some of you might be going through a divorce. You have been waiting for it, like you are waiting for it, and now after that decision is made, you are seeing other people. Now, Two of Pentacles along with Justice here, I'm getting that you really want to maintain balance between whatever that you are dealing with right now, like two people, two jobs or something like that. Balance is very prominent in this reading, and you are waiting for something to come your way. You are trying to keep your patience, you are trying to wait for your gains. Now, Two of Cups energy is telling me that you want mutual respect and mutual exchange of feelings with somebody. One more flipper here, Son of Cups with the Mother of Sword. So there can be somebody or you trying to offer your love to a air sign like Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, or a water sign, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising. But this offer can be a little bit immature in a way that there is nothing that has developed much. You are just meeting this person, or you went out for like one or two dates, and there is exchange of emotions, and there is some conversation which is like heart touching, heart to heart conversations are happening. But at the same time, somebody is being very someone is here being very cold. Now this can be you who is trying to rely on your logical side, or this is the other person who can be a little, this person can also be a widowed person. I'm getting like I just felt like saying that this person can be very cold because they have been through a lot of harsh reality, or they have faced harsh situations in their life. Yes. Okay. Temperance, bottom of the center of this reading is Temperance, five of wands crossing, Sun of Pentacles is grounding it, four of wands in the past, Father of Wands on your mind, and then three of swords, seven of cups, two of swords, nine of pentacles, and four of cups with three of pentacles. So this reading feels like a reading where Pisces is mostly like I said, you're trying to maintain a balance. Again, a balance card, trying to keep your patience amongst things that are coming towards you. Like there are a lot of ideas and a lot of gossip or chatter that is coming your way, a lot of competition or people who are coming your way, a lot of distraction that is being pushed on you. Like people are either trying to grab your attention for their benefit, and you are amidst all of this chaos, you are trying to maintain your balance, you want to keep your peace, you want to not get pulled into their drama. Now the Sun of Pentacles is the grounding reading, is someone who is studying, someone who is working really hard on their work. They plan ahead, they move steadily, they are very focused and diligent in their dealings. This person does not budge, this person does not get deviated. So this can be you studying something or mastering something or on your way to do something great. This is a very dedicated energy where you are invested in something for a very long time. Like you want to accomplish something for a long period of time, like something that will last. So you know that you have to put in effort and you have to be very tactical. So you are taking stock of the situation, and you are understanding what is your potential, and you are trying to put in the effort that is required from your end in order to accomplish that that you wish to accomplish, in order to sit pretty, enjoy your legacy. So you are still focused and in the work mode right now. Since Three of Pentacles is the overall energy, it's definitely work card. So you are trying to make it work with other people, or you are working somewhere and you're very focused about your work. You can also be traveling with respect to your work. There is something that you had left in the past, like an idea or a person, and you wanted to start afresh, but you want to now look back and take something good that happened in the past, and you want to incorporate it into your new project. So you are taking bits and pieces, some idea or some expertise that you had developed in the past, some skill, some knowledge that you had in the past, and you are trying to bring it into present, and you want to implement it, you want to take it forward. in past you had stability, you had home, like a very cozy home or a very peaceful home. This is coming up in past energy. So you gained some commitment or you became serious about something. It can be a person, it can be a work situation where you started doing something new, something which was solid or on solid ground. It had a very beautiful foundation and it was reliable. Now what's on your mind is Father of Wands. So either you are dealing with a fire sign, Leo, I'm also getting Aquarius, Leo, Aries, or I'm also getting Gemini, Sagittarius. So Father of Wands on your mind is pretty much somebody who is either trying to push you to do better, or this person is an inspiration for you, or this person is trying to be the attention of this entire thing. This can be you as well, trying to entertain somebody or trying to go after your dream. This person is a go-getter. They only relax after they have achieved their ambition, their dreams and desires. This person has a lot of passion and they do not hesitate from going out there and get their stuff done and get their ideas rolling. They are ready to take center stage and ready to speak about their ideas, and they are ready to materialize it into reality. So this can be you, or you're dealing with somebody like this, or you're thinking about someone who is like that, someone who holds attention, someone who is quite popular. Now in future you do have Three of Swords. So Three of Swords is telling me in future that either you are going to have a heartbreak in future regarding a Sagittarius person, or a home situation where there was a commitment, because somebody is either distracted by a lot of people or they are flirtatious. So you can have a Three of Swords situation where you might discover something painful. So whatever this is which is painful, you are coming up in your reading is as Seven of Cups. This person is very like in a dream state. So in Pisces is ruled by Jupiter and Neptune. Jupiter is also the ruler of Sagittarius, and Jupiter has gone direct in this sign of Sagittarius recently, and Neptune is going to go direct in the sign of Pisces on 24th of November, I guess. So be mindful of that energy where Neptune is going direct, because then you at that point of time, moving from that point of time, as a Piscean, you are going to feel like you are expanding, you are doing something big, you are thinking something like a unrealistic dream. Guys, I'm really sorry about the sound which is coming from outside. So yeah, you with Sagittarius and Neptune, you can feel that you are expanding and you have so much brilliant ideas, and you might be getting philosophical, and you can get like all embroiled up in fantasy, and you can pull wool over your own eyes in coming few months, because as a Pisces, you are very susceptible to daydreaming, you are susceptible to victim mentality, you are susceptible to escapism. You can escape your problems and not see the reality. You will try to avoid reality and not face it. You will try to not confront people who are probably misleading you. You will, in fact, you might even make it easier for them to mislead you or manipulate you, because you don't want to hurt them, or you don't want to. Because basically Pisces also suffers from martyr syndrome, so don't try to get into that entire trap of being a nice guy or being a nice girl or a nice human being. And like, you know, I'm not saying don't be nice, I'm just saying don't get stuck there. Like, ask for your worth, ask for your respect, demand it, and don't let people walk all over you. And the most important thing here is that do not try to suppress your pain. Guys, I'm sorry about the train. Do not try to suppress your pain and do not try to romanticize about your pain and your sadness and sorrow, because romanticizing your pain and sadness, like being a damsel in distress, I'm not saying that you are like that, I'm just saying be mindful of it, because Neptune can do that, because Neptune is a planet which almost governs film industry, glamour, all that glitter and all that zazz basically. So be mindful of that energy, don't get carried away, be ground yourself in reality, put in effort in your, if you want to accomplish some dream, don't forget to put effort in this, don't forget to be practical and realistic about your dreams, don't get carried away by Jupiter's energy where you feel like you can accomplish anything and becoming overconfident because you have such imagination, like, you know, Pisces ruled by Neptune, which is the planet of imagination and deception as well. So you might even deceive yourself with all the imagination going on. So be mindful of that, Pisces, because people here can see that you are very confused. You are taking on too many things probably, and you're not able to accomplish any of them because you are not able to make a decision. You are not able to decide which path to take, which way to go, which is the right option for me. For some of you, you are going to for a higher study and you have some spiritual awakenings as well, like some changes in belief, and some of you might be traveling with respect to your work, like I said. Now, what else I'm getting here is that someone around you is not able to decide on something, or you are not able to decide about something. And your hope is that you are self-sufficient and financially not dependent on anybody else. Your fear can be that you fear loneliness and you fear being single for a very long time. You might fear that nobody is going to come your way or you won't get anyone in future. So drop that fear, because we should understand that we have a relationship with our own self that needs as much attention and time. Whatever amount of time that we can give to our own self is not enough, because we have so much to discover about ourselves, and we may not have company of other people, but we must treasure our company, and we must try to spend more time with ourselves and uncovering layers about ourselves. We can discover new things about ourselves. Now, with the Four of Cups as the outcome, I'm getting here that you can be offered something, but you might not take that offer because you feel that you deserve more. You might feel that there will be more opportunities for you in the future, which would be better than the opportunities that you are getting right now. So you might reject the offer, or you are offering somebody something and they are rejecting your offer. They might be rejecting your offer because they want something more, or they don't even understand what you are offering them. So if you really want this person to understand what you are offering, explain it to them and let them know what you are really, really offering them. Now let's see what are the clarifiers. One thing that I'm getting very clearly here, Pisces, is that everything is in your hand. Universe is not doing much for you in the month of December. Everything is about you. If you want to do something, you can do it. and you will get the results. If you do not want to do anything, you don't have to do anything and you won't get any results. There are few themes in this reading which I'm getting is that either you wish to start something and you want to defend yourself or your position in society. You really want to make a new start and a new beginning, either with an Aries person who is being defensive towards you, or you are being defensive towards this person, and you are wanting to offer this person something, or this person is probably trying to offer you something. So on your mind, yes, you feel very selfless and serving. You want to serve people. You want to be selfless. You want to be speaking about your ideas and emotion, but you are burdening yourself. That's one message that I'm getting. Like, you feel very burdened, or you are burdening yourself, especially if you are dealing with a water sign or a Aries, Leo, Sag person. Now, in past, either somebody was trying to save some money for a house. This person can be a Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, or this is you trying to save really, really hard, or trying to maintain. Build stability for yourself with giving it your extra. You are working extra hard to provide yourself with stability. You are working like you, after breaking a very toxic cycle, you have been working really hard to build yourself some stability here. Now let's see what else is coming. Your challenge is that you are not able to trust your intuition. You are not able to move to a peaceful spot. Like, you are feeling that you cannot trust your intuition, or you will stay stuck in a situation which is very confusing or full of conflict or full of egoistic battles and bickering. So you need to trust yourself more, Pisces. Here is what one of the messages that I'm getting, because the center of this reading is that you have a new beginning, a fresh start, a Ace of Pentacles here with a Temperance card and Nine of Cups. So if you decide to start something fresh from the beginning, if you take this opportunity and you decide that you want to build on this foundation, you keep your patience with this for the entire journey. Like, you start something and you keep your patience for months and years, you will have a wish fulfillment here. Or you are having a wish fulfillment with a earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, or even a water sign, Sun, Moon, Rising, or a Sagittarius person. But if you keep your balance with this person, you will get some relief, or you will have a wish fulfillment. Another Pisces person can be your challenge, Sun, Moon, Rising. Now, with the heartbreak, the card that I'm getting here is that the heartbreak is coming from a twin flame or a soulmate. This person can again like be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You were waiting for this person for a very long time, and maybe your ships are coming in. Like, this person is probably coming back, and they probably see you as somebody who is a wife material, or who will look after the house, or something of that nature is coming up. Or you look at this person like that, but there is some heartbreak. Maybe this person is not coming. That's one of the messages that I'm getting. Maybe you are just waiting and this person doesn't turns up, and that breaks your heart. Now, your hopes and fears is that you hope that like, either you are able to maintain your emotions, or this somebody that you are dealing with, they will be very kind and loving and emotional, but there is fight with this person. Can be a water sign, like fight in a way that you both are not able to drop your egos. That is your fear. So that's one of the messages. That's not actually happening, but that's one of the fear that you have, that maybe you both won't be able to drop your fears. With the confusion and all the fantasy, Son of Cups and Daughter of Wands, you are very excited about something. You want to start fresh, and you are very passionate about something, and you want to begin. But at the same time, you have to line up your thoughts and your ideas, and you have to write them down. You cannot be haphazard. You have to be very meticulous and detailed, and you need to write the plan down before you can take up an idea and make it reality. Now with the Sun of Cups and Seven of Cups, you might be imagining or you might have a option or a lot of options regarding getting you know, a lot of people asking you out, and you may not know which one is genuine. But the message that I'm getting here is that do whatever that you want to do with a lot of authenticity, and put your heart in it. If it's a project that you are starting, or you are in the middle of some project, I'm also getting here that someone will come with on your way, like towards you, with a offer, a emotional offer. But I don't know what you're going to do with that offer. The only thing that I'm understanding here is that you have to keep your patience. Patience, because Seven of Pentacles is about patience, and your this energy is also about patience. So maybe you are trying to defend yourself in society, or you are trying to just defend your position in a way that you want to start something new, and you don't want to be the oppressed one or the one who is ignored. You don't want to be the person who is taken for granted. So while trying to work something on your own, you are also being called off by people around you who are trying to grab your attention, but they are not offering anything concrete to you, is one of the messages that I am getting. In your surrounding, there can be a person who is a three-party situation. This person can be dealing this person can be either an air sign, or they are dating an air sign, or they are talking to an air sign. So if you are in a three-party, that's the message that I'm getting. This other person that they are probably dating, or this person themselves, is either a widow, or this person has gone through a lot of tough times, and they can also be dealing with somebody who is a no-nonsense person, or you are just dealing with somebody like that. Like, this person wants, they want to get to the point, and they do not wait, they do not get entangled in emotions. Now the outcome card is the Strength and the Ten of Pentacles and the Four of Cups. The energy that I'm getting here is that either you are rejecting a Leo person, or Leo person is rejecting you, and you have to be very brave with the rejection, or you have to be very graceful while rejecting somebody or while accepting a rejection. This rejection can also be in family, like you are dealing with a Leo person in family, or there is some idea that is floated in family and somebody is not happy with those ideas or the love that they are being offered. So they want more love, and they want more stability, they want more prosperity. So there is some dissatisfaction at family, in family, or somebody who is a Leo person. You have to be very graceful in this situation, where you are not able to either satisfy someone, or you yourself are not satisfied. So you have to keep your grace with that situation, because it's an obstacle for you. You not feeling good at home, or you feeling like emotionally you're not feeling fulfilled. So it's only a month. You need to just get through it, because the main energy here is that you are starting something new at workplace, and your focus should be there, because otherwise people around you are offering you something non-sincere, insincere, and they are not sure what do they really want from you, or what they are offering you. So since I see that in past you were trying to maintain stability for yourself, and in your hopes and desire you want to be financially independent, and another energy was keeping your temper, or keeping control on your emotions is one of the major energy. I think the Pisces reading here that I have done right now is more about how you should not get stuck with the Neptunian energy, like feeling like you have fallen in love with somebody, but that person is not actually the right one for you, because they just aren't, and you are not able to see that they are not your type, because you are eager to believe in them, you are eager to fall for the story, you don't want to face reality. So I think one of the major lesson for the Pisces who are watching this video is that please remember that Neptune was in retrograde for a very long time in the sign of Pisces, and you could see everything clearly. But on 24th of November onwards, Neptune is going direct, and your rose-colored glasses are going to come on, like back on, and you might start, you know, getting into that foggy area, not knowing what to do, or doing things which are not practical or real. So please ground yourself. Put in the work, put in the effort, do, like, you know, take action, and do not fall back into your dream land. I'm not saying it's wrong, because I do it, but what's important is not forgetting that you need some grounding. So do not just be in the clouds. Try to ground your dreams and your desires, and go for it. So let's see what's your blockage here, Pisces. Blockage card for Pisces for Sun, Moon, Rising, December reading. Blockage for Pisces. What's blocking Pisces for the month of December? I am not getting any blockage for you, Pisces. I'm just getting that everything is in your hand. It's up to you what you do. And the card out for you is Victim. So this is very Neptunian energy. Like I said, you can go into that martyr syndrome sort of situation where you want to sacrifice for other people and romanticize sadness and that's what I'm getting. And then you have enlightenment. So take whichever path you want to take. Either you sit in this position where you are acting like a victim or coming from a space of victimhood, or you just be enlightened and understand that everything is in your hand, and you will get whatever you work for, and whatever you are bold enough to dream and bold enough to go out and get. Out there, like, you know, you need to just go out and get it. And enlightenment is also about, like I said, Jupiter is about changing your belief system, religious belief system especially, and forming your own ideas, and having, like, changing your philosophy about life, how you think about life, how you think about love, how you think about sacrifice, how you think about reality, what is reality and what is a dream, and how important, and how is it possible to bring your reality bring your dreams into reality. So how do you do that? So enlightenment can be in any form. So I think for Pisces, enlightenment is all about, since they are always in another world, it's enlightenment for them is that they become human. Because Pisces doesn't even feel like a human, so they, what's important for them is to feel like a human and act like a human and achieve like a human being. Pisces does not want to be there. They don't want to be bounded in a human body doing regular stuff. They don't want to be limited by their surrounding. They don't want to be limited by their humanness. They are limitless. They know that they are a spirit and nothing can stop them, and they know that they are one with God or the Almighty or the superpower. So it's difficult for them to live in this dimension. So I think enlightenment for Pisces is all about how to work with reality, how to work with real people, how to understand them and behave in accordance with them, and not live in a utopia where everything is good, where everything is nice and everyone is nice. Don't live in that world, Pisces. This world is, you know how it is, right? So keep being nice, but don't be a fool, Pisces. And give me one more card for Pisces. Sun, Moon, Rising. what is already with you. What is already with you? The card is asking you what is already with you that you can work with, that you can you can put to use, and you can start building something new and liberate yourself. Whatever is already with you is all that you need to do something great in life and going beyond normal. So my last message for you was like, Pisces cannot be normal, and the card is all about going beyond normal. Maybe you need to bring your ideas into reality in a way that normal people cannot. So believe in your ideas so much and try to either do law of attraction or either do intention setting, whatever you do, Pisces, just find out ways how can you bring things into form. So focus on that question. And people might think that you are abnormal, and people might think that you are weird, but go with it. Like, believe in your heart and soul and your spirit. Do not get bogged down by what other people are saying. Do it. Do what your heart says, Pisces. So that was your reading, Pisces. I'll pull out two more cards here with respect to this. Give me two keywords for Pisces. Keywords for December for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising. First card out is clarity. I cannot help but take this card because Neptunian energy is all about being unclear, being foggy, but this is all about clarity. Clearing your mind brings you closer to the sacred inner wisdom. And there is luck, which is a Jupiter card. So Jupiter in Sagittarius is going to help Pisces as well, because like I said, Jupiter is ruling planet of Pisces as well. With a clear direction of what you want to achieve, you are summoning energy that bring good luck. And then you have dreams, which is again a very Neptunian Piscean card. Dreams are an expression of collective experiences combined with messages from the spirit world. So spirits are going to try to, they will try to contact you, they will try to give you ideas, they will try to support you, they will try to pave your path, they will try to bring some obstacle in your way so that you can learn something new and you will be able to add that skill in your toolbox where you knew how to handle a very tough situation, so you were able to do it. And then the other card that came out for you is patience. This reading was all about patience, clarity, luck and dreams. So I'm happy that I pulled out these cards because they confirm the message for you, Pisces. Nurture the seeds of patience and reap the rewards of personal achievement. So yes, this is all about you, all about you. Even universe is not interfering with you right now. Whatever you do is going to be your destiny. Whatever you decide, whatever you choose, it's your free will. With that, I will end your reading, Pisces. Please drop me a comment if you feel connected with the reading. That will really help me assess my work and bring a smile on my face. Let's see if I'll be posting for the year 2019, because I'm not getting the kind of response that I wanted. I've been posting for over a year now, and my channel is growing a little bit slow, on a very slow pace. And I'm a student, so I have a lot of project that I deal with. So I want to prioritize what I'm being, good at, and I should be focused on, because to be very honest, I need to see results as well. So yeah, take care guys, and happy new year, and Merry Christmas to all of you.